Calabash TV's Celebrate Creativity is made possible through our presenting sponsors, Saul EC Limited, Jean-Marie and Sons, EC Global, and Digicel.
When we were growing up, I think it got to a point where my dad actually built a stage for us, because we'd be putting on, me and my sisters would put on little productions. Mm-hmm. And then it happened that, after I think my mom kind of clocked on to the fact that I wanted to dance, but the issue for me was I didn't want to join a dance group because I was thinking, oh, I'll be the only guy. And then I remember I was at Hess, I think I was in Form 3 at the time, and mom said, okay, so I've signed you up for a term at Crystallite. You start next week. And then for me, I thought, okay, she's like, just go see if you like it. And then I started off, and I mean, I'd done like little dance workshops, like in summer workshops before as a kid. But that kind of was like, okay, cool. I went, I got hooked, and that was me. And that's kind of, I think, where the passion started a lot. I mean, I'd always loved performing. My God, I'm breathing out and do all. Something like freedom.
Freedom. My God, I'm breathing out and do all.
So I'd been on stage from quite young, but I think that's when I kind of really started kicking off my passion for dance. It's been quite a journey, especially leaving home, little Caribbean boy with braces, like glasses on, and going up to England. And literally I felt a lot of the time like, I don't know, things were handed to me, almost being the right place at the right time, where, I don't know, something as well with, I almost say, we come from a place where we're seasoned in some ways, and we have this experience, which, I mean, I went up there, we're so hungry for stuff. I went up and I was like, oh, cool, is this opportunity? Okay, okay, cool, this for free? I was like, okay, I'll do that. And it's from that I kind of ended up meeting people, and that's kind of how things sort of snowballed into kind of where it is today.
What is the biggest culture shock you got? Because you had been having a certain dance orientation here.
Yeah.
Once you landed and you got involved, what was the biggest shock for you?
Well, I think, I mean, if I look at it and when I think back to when I was living here in St Lucia, I mean, the focus when you think of dance, I think, and as well, you heard a lot of people say, oh, you know, we're so stuck in the same thing. So we always do a little dance with like the white skirt and the fans. And then, so you do a little wine on stage and everyone's happy, you get claps and stuff. And then I went over there thinking, okay, cool, I'm just going to wind up, and then realizing, oh, wow, there's so much more within the dancers. For me, even physically, it was a shock because, say, stuff like ballet, normally you train from when you're much younger. So I, like, started ballet properly, like, taking class when I was about 18. So thinking anatomically, like, my body was somewhat already fixed. So whereas, say, if you work from younger, you kind of, like, your body develops with this sort of practice. For me, I'm almost fighting against my body to get into positions. To suddenly, I went from being flat-footed African dancer. Oh, you need to point your feet, and it's it was quite a shock for me. Also, culturally, there's this also the competition levels, as in the number of people in which you're going against for, like, say, a job. And also the context of things is, yeah, it's very different here. So for me, that was quite, I think, a massive shock. And also, again, but at the same time, I learned so much from it that I think that's where, I don't know, I started getting ideas. I thought, okay, cool, it'd be really good to come back and, like, share something, some of the stuff that I learned. And as well, it's kind of when I left here years ago, my first experience of contemporary dance was watching Seven Dance Company perform at the Cultural Center. Never seen contemporary dance before. And suddenly you see these two bodies sinuously sort of moving. I thought, wow, that's quite cool. I've never seen anything like that. They're not wearing white skirts running around with like African drums, which for me, I loved. And but it was like, this was something somewhat different. And I think that's kind of where the curiosity sort of grew from there.
Transformed into an animal.
If anything could happen in a person's mind.
This is not my mind.
decided to do a degree in contemporary dance, obviously. Yeah. I'm sure you had options at the time. And what convinced you that this is what you ought to be studying at this point? Like you already had dance as a solid background.
Yeah. Well, it's for it. Kind of, how do I say? I live life by this sort of rule where, okay, if it seems right at the time, I do it. And I think it's funny because I guess when you compare it, like say my mom, for example, she knew from the time she was however young, she wanted to be a nurse, she wanted to do it. I've always changed, okay, today I want to do this, today I want to do that. And I always said, like, for example, right now the opportunity has been given to me to go to a dance school to study for 3 years. And I want to go there to get the experience. But I also knew if I came out and I said, okay, cool, I've danced for 3 years at school, I actually don't want to be a dancer anymore, I'll be happy with that. Like, I don't try to think or put limitations in that, oh, because I've studied that, then that's what I have to do for the rest of my life. But at the time, it's kind of what I really wanted to do. And that opportunity allowed me to get the training that I wanted to get. So I think that's kind of why I jumped on it, to be honest. It just came out of nowhere, to be honest. But I think for me, actually, it was the right decision.
When we come to see the teddy bear here to play, if you don't come play with us, then we will kill you.
Now, you mentioned a while ago film.
Yeah.
So that means you're involved with film. What else are you involved with?
Whilst I was dancing with Hagi Ikira Dance, I even though, for example, you're dancing with someone, sometimes I felt like I hadn't been doing anything or generating work myself. Because if I look back to all the careers I wanted, from like being a chef, I always had this creative sort of, I need to create, I need to make something. And I was in this point where I was like, oh, I just feel really creatively stagnant. So I picked up my camera and I started filming. I asked a couple of friends of mine, cool, I just went for 3 hours, I just want to film this, I have this idea, I want to make this. And then I made a film, which I then submitted to the Dance for Festival UK, which then went on to win an award. And I was like, oh, that's quite cool. And then so then from there, I did another couple other films. Then I had, because I was
mainly dance films.
Mainly dance films I started off doing. And then someone else saw my work as a yoga instructor, then she wanted me to do like a film for her. I was like, oh, cool, I get paid to do this. This is quite cool. And then after I did another shoot, where normally I do everything on my own. I did everything from the makeup to the styling to you name it, I had to do it. Because I'm just doing it out of my own pocket. And then once I had a team, and one of the makeup artists was like, oh, you should do stuff for fashion. And I was like, fashion? It's like, okay. So it's like, hey, you should take photos and submit to magazines. Well, that's quite interesting. So then that's where photography kind of started. So I kind of fell into film and photography, and I kind of sort of did it casually before, but it became somewhat a new outlet, which I, especially in the last year, has kind of become almost my thing now. Recently, so I've moved a bit into fashion, but yeah, it's been quite exciting, especially for me still being able to merge. And now a lot of the people I work with are dancers and artists who I know, because again, for me, it's being able to still be creative and still have that link with the arts. And now I've become the resident filmmaker and photographer for the company I was in, so everything seems to be all interchangeable and interconnected.
We fight it back for no reason, but ourselves.
Calabash TV's Celebrate Creativity is made possible through our presenting sponsors, Sol EC Limited, Jean-Marie & Sons, EC Global, and Digicel.